Option traders especially, but all traders, hear about implied volatility and how it affects your trading strategy. Our guest today is Dan Passarelli. He's an options expert here to talk about implied volatility. So Dan, first of all, let's define it. What is implied volatility?
In simple terms, implied volatility is the volatility component embedded in an options price. We could get a little bit fancier with that, but in a nutshell, that's really it. And the analogy that I like to use a lot is people talk about options being insurance policies, right? You can insure a stock by buying a put. Well, just like with any other insurance policy, take a car insurance, for example. If somebody's a really reckless driver, the insurance company thinks they're a big risk. And so they charge them a higher premium for their policy. Somebody who is a very safe driver, well, the insurance policy thinks that they're not a big risk, so they pay a lot less. That's exactly how options work. And that component that sort of measures, you know, that perception of risk or perception of volatility, that's implied volatility.
All right, so when I read articles about options, I read about the implieds increasing or the implieds decreasing. What are they talking about there?
In a nutshell, it's relatively, how expensive are options? You know, like, obviously calls make money as the stock goes up and lose money as the stock goes down, but what if the stock doesn't go up or down? Options can still get more or less expensive. And that nuance of an options price is called implied volatility.
All right, so when I'm talking about just volatility overall of the market and that the VIX is low, is that the same thing?
Yeah, it's exactly the same thing. And the VIX is a great benchmark because that tells you, hey, just overall, how expensive are options? Are they cheap to buy right now, or are they really expensive to buy right now? You know, people look at the S&P 500 or the SPX index as a benchmark for, hey, how are stocks doing? Well, the VIX, that's just a benchmark for, hey, how are options doing? Cheap or expensive?
We've had low volatility for a long time here. I know that puts a crimp in a lot of people's options strategies. Do you differ in your decision-making personally when you're trading options in a low volatility environment?
Yeah, because when options are cheaper, I might implement more option buying strategies instead of option selling strategies. Because, you know, it's really common to do both with options. I can be, you know, I can do things like income trading, iron condors and butterflies and such, or I can do things like volatility buying long calls or long puts or long straddles. So when volatility is really cheap, I'm more apt to buy those options because in relative terms, they're cheaper.
All right, so on an option chain, how do I view implied volatility? Is it a number, or what does it look like?
Yeah, most option-friendly brokers allow you to configure a column that has implied volatility in there. And it's probably displayed 0.25. There might be a percentage sign afterwards. If there's not a percentage sign, you can just kind of read that in. They just sort of left it off, but it is a percentage. And what it is, it's the annualized standard deviation. That's the units that it's measured in. So it's basically a percentage of the stock price in terms of annualized standard deviation.
And am I looking for a specific number? Will months that are further out in expiration have a lower implied or a higher implied volatility? And what does that tell me about which one I should be buying or selling?
Yeah, further out months may have a higher implied, or they may have lower implieds. It's called the term structure volatility or horizontal skew. And you know, if you're trying to decide, hey, I want to do an option selling strategy, but I'm not sure if I should sell, you know, the Mays or the Junes, well, which is more expensive? If you want to sell options, wouldn't you rather sell the more expensive options? So look at that term structure volatility, and if you're selling, sell the higher month. If you're buying, buy the lower month.
Dan, thanks for being here.
Thanks, Tim.
You're watching the MoneyShow.com video network.